Blinds 8,000, 16,000 with a 2,000 ante. Action is on, Lonnie Harwood. A7 suited under the gun.
A lot of players struggle with what to do with medium suited aces under the gun. Let's see what a good player does.
She raises to 32,000.
So you can raise with them.
Pocket fours for Fabian Ortiz in the cutoff. He calls. Gámez in from the button with 8-6. Sorrell and Mert fold the blinds. Three-way to the flop.
Uh-oh, clubs on clubs. Rooting for a clubby train wreck right now, straight out of the Jersey Shore.
Only one club, but an ace for Lonnie and a four for Ortiz. He's ahead with a set.
So this could very well be a train wreck.
Lonnie continues for 47,000.
I think Lonnie can actually check that there. Not sure how much value there is in betting.
Ortiz just calls. Gámez folds, heads up to the turn. King of diamonds changes nothing. Lonnie slows down. She checks.
There we go. I like slowing down here. And it looks like John Leguizamo's dad's going to go for value.
Ortiz bets 125,000.
And I think he's playing this hand very well. Lonnie's got a lot of aces in her range and lots of hands that caught some equity on the turn. I like this bet. It's tough to fold top pair, but I think that might be the move here.
All in.
Wow, she moves all in. Oh. Ortiz calls. And Lonnie's drawing dead. She's out.
I don't want to say that was a mistake, but that stormtrooper who whacks his head in the background of that scene in Star Wars now suddenly doesn't feel so bad.
Good luck, guys.
An irrelevant river card gets dealt as Lonnie Harwood leaves the tournament.
Yeah, good luck to you.
That was a tough one.
Fabian Ortiz up to 1.6 million. And no ladies remain in the 2014 PCA main event.
Way to bring her luck, Jen Shahadi.
Roger Teske is being pulled aside by one of the tournament staff.
This is it. No more drinking for the rest of the night, okay?
Ah.
All right. You don't want me to get my ball. No more drinking, all right?
How can you tell me whether or not I can drink or not? I haven't been offensive to anybody. I want a TV camera on me right now. It's an unreasonable request. At no point was I discourteous to anybody at the table, dealers, or waitstaff.
You say you were. I said enough drinking. You know, I'll get my boss if you want. That's all.
That's not up to you. That's my decision.
I'll get him for you. Okay.
You get him for me. You get him for me. And you order me a cocktail, waitress, while you're at it.
Roger Teske is not a happy man. He's 3-bet Mike McDonald pre-flop. And we've only seen one of Roger's cards.
Is it because he can only open one eye?
Mike calls.
Maybe he's seeing double and thinks he has two aces.
Mike playing this flop out of position, but don't worry about position. He's flopped a set.
Mike's really hoping Teske has got aces now.
McDonald playing in flow, checks the man with a preflop betting lead. Teske continues for 75K.
Spoiler alert, this C-bet isn't going to work and everyone on Game of Thrones dies.
McDonald throws in three green chips. He calls.
At least for Teske's sake, the bet was small. Maybe he does have aces.
Five on the turn. McDonald checks a second time. Teske checks behind.
Ace's theory losing ground. I don't think he'd check over pairs on that turn.
Nine on the river.
And because of that, I think some folks might be inclined to check here and try to induce a bluff, but Mike might figure since Roger's been drinking, he can take him right home to Value Town, get a little value-y back at his place.
Roger has been drinking? Looks like Roger is still drinking. Facing a bet of 250,000 from Mike.
Yeah, Roger is ready to go home with you, pal. Oh, don't touch the chips. Or the cards. Oh, can we get a wet wipe?
Teske folds.
Button moved.
The last hand of the day. Roger Teske, once again, a tad tired and emotional, facing a 4-bet from Mattis Moore.
Mattis Moore 4-betting the guy who's 4 sheets to the wind.
A call?
A cab, hopefully.
277.5? That's two.
Just trust the dealer.
275.2. We got there eventually. Mert way ahead. But Teske catches a piece on the flop.
Fun flop for Queens.
Mert continues for 202,000.
You gotta bet it because there's so many draws out there.
And Roger calls.
Teske's hand would sometimes be good, but it's not easy to improve.
Well, the seven on the turn gives him a gut shot.
Not a great card for Queens, and you can see why Murr would want to play a slightly smaller pot now.
He checks. And Teska checks behind.
Once Roger checks the turn, I think Mattis has an easy value bet on the river.
The river is a four. Murr with a lock on the hand. Clearly going to go for value. Question is how much. That is 377,000.
I think Roger Teska strapped on a pair of beer goggles.
You know, I'm trying to make a call right now, so convince me that I should.
Murr would never take this line as a bluff, and I don't think he's ever value betting worse.
Where did that drink come from? I thought they cut him off.
He's just getting a read here. Look at this. It's amazing. Also, why is the room spinning?
Teska calls! And loses nearly a million chips to Mattis Murr.
Murr knew exactly what he was doing there.
Oops.
I don't think it needs any more commentary than that.